St George Peace Memorial Church here in East Ivanhoe in the northeastern suburbs of Melbourne, Australia. A warm welcome to those of you who are joining us from our faith community around this city of Melbourne and abroad in Switzerland, France, the United Kingdom and the United States of America. You are all very much in our thoughts and prayers as we gather here in this sacred place, this grand building designed by Boyd and Romberg, as we gather for this Maundy Thursday Eucharist of the Lord's Supper with the washing of feet. We gather at a time of pandemic, a time of stress, fear, a time of death and grief. May this time with us be a time of peace. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God's kingdom now and forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Tonight we begin the great 3 days of our Lord's Passion, Death and Resurrection. The journey from the supper table to the cross, from the cross to the Easter door. We are followers in his way, exploring his truth, encountering his life. This is the night when Christ, the Lamb of God, gave himself into the hands of those who would betray him. This is the night when Christ gathered with his disciples in the upper room. This is the night when Christ our Lord gave us this holy feast, that as we break the bread and drink the cup, we may here proclaim his holy sacrifice and come at the last to his table in heaven. This is the night when Christ took a towel and washed the disciples' feet, showing us how to honour and serve one another in love. This is the night for watching and prayer. We give ourselves freely to the demands of these great days, confident that those who die in Christ will surely live with him. God shows great love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Let us then confess our sins in penitence and faith. Merciful God, our Maker and our Judge, we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We repent and are sorry for all our sins. Father, forgive us. Strengthen us to love and obey you in newness of life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to him in faith, pardon you and set you free from all your sins, strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray that we may love others as Christ has loved us. Holy God, source of all love, on the night of his betrayal, Jesus gave his disciples a new commandment, to love one another as he loved them. Write this commandment in our hearts, and give us the will to serve others as he was the servant of all, who gave his life and died for us, yet is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one and share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it, with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand. You shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt, I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and, after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, also the cup, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. I give you a new commandment, says the Lord. Love one another as I have loved you.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Now, before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put it into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" And Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash, except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he who knew who was to betray him, for this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet, had put on his robe, and had returned to the table, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done for you? You shall call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example, that you also should do as I have done to you. Very truly I tell you, servants are not greater than their master, nor are messengers greater than the one who sent them. If you know these things, you are blessed if you do them." When he had gone out, Jesus said, "Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me. And as I said to the Jews, so I now say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. And by this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us pray for the whole Church of God in Christ Jesus, and for all people according to their need. Almighty God, on this night of his betrayal, when your Son, Jesus Christ, washed his disciples' feet, we commit ourselves to follow his example of love and service. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
On this night, Jesus prayed for his disciples to be one. We pray for the unity of your Church. Gather into one communion all your scattered servants. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
On this night, Jesus prayed for those who were to believe through the disciples' message. We pray for the ministry and mission of your Church. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
On this night, Jesus commanded his disciples to love, but he suffered rejection himself. As we open our hearts to the rejected and the unloved, fill us with your love. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
On this night, Jesus reminded his people that if the world hated them, it had hated him first. As we face our own fears, we pray for those who are persecuted for their faith. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
On this night, Jesus loved his friends to the very end. As we open our hearts to all who face darkness tonight, we pray for the sick, those who mourn, those trapped by violence, addiction or pain. Give healing and hope. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Faithful God, these are the prayers of your Church. We offer them trusting and hoping in you. Hear and help us, challenge and change us, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Christ has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have these gifts to share. Accept and use our offerings for your glory and for the service of your kingdom.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Give them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
All glory and honour be yours always and everywhere, mighty Creator, ever-living God. We give you thanks and praise for your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who became obedient even death on a cross. He offered the one true sacrifice for sin and obtained an eternal deliverance for his people. When his hour had come in his great love, he gave this supper to his disciples, that we might proclaim his death and feast with him in his kingdom. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Merciful God, we thank you for these gifts of your creation, this bread and wine. We pray that by your word and Holy Spirit, we who eat and drink them may be partakers of Christ's body and blood. On the night he was betrayed, Jesus took bread, and when he had given you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup, and again, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Therefore we do as our Saviour has commanded, proclaiming his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect and sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. Renew us by your Holy Spirit, unite us in the body of your Son, and bring us with all your people into the joy of your eternal kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father, in songs of never-ending praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power are yours forever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour Christ has taught us, we are confident to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. body of Christ. We who are many are one body, for we all share in the one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us your peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Let us pray. Holy God, source of all love, on the night of betrayal, Jesus commanded his disciples to love one another as he loved them. We thank you for feeding us in this supper. Give us the will to serve others, as he was the servant of all.